I'm Chris Lockhart. Thanks for tuning in to the video podcast. This is Consultants Saying Things, Episode 2, the one about digital transformation. I wanted to do a little bit of a video intro kind of after the fact to kind of give you the context behind this episode. We actually got it from one of the LinkedIn comments from our first video, Episode 1. And the question was, well, what about digital transformation? Do that one next. And so we sat down in our Google Hangout and just started riffing. We weren't actually intending to record and use that footage, but it turned out that we had actually a lot to say about digital transformation, about disruption, about automation, about a bunch of other things. We talked for like an hour and a half. So I had to spend quite a bit of time editing that down to something that is consumable. I hope you enjoy it. A little bit of a cautionary note. We have Bill's video didn't actually record. He was in the Google Hangout, but we didn't get any of his video. So the audio's there. That's good, but you'll just hear his voice sort of coming from the sky. Other than that, I think it's pretty good. Good stuff. I hope you enjoy this episode. I give you Consultants Saying Things, Episode 2, the one about digital transformation.
Okay, so... So I just threw out digital transformation as a topic, and Shashi rightly pointed out, like, that's this big. So I don't know if we want to break it down, have like a smaller chunk. I threw out some questions that I am curious about. If you Google what do you need to know about digital transformation, or just Google digital transformation, like, every article is 10 things you need to know by Gartner, 9 things you need to know. 7 things, right? And it's like, God, everyone's already done a list, right? So,
you know, I was going through and putting some talking points together based upon, Sasha, what you were saying, and Chris, what you put together. And people talk about digital transformation, but it's this broad abstract concept. So I started just trying to define to myself, what is digital transformation? And some of the talking points that I put down here is like sort of dispelling the consultant speak about digital transformation, where it's coming in and let me build you an app, or let me do this technology. And getting down to the real hypothesis is about it being a cultural shift towards using digital and human computer interaction to provide business value instead of mechanical interaction providing business value.
I deal with this whole, this topic is pretty close to my heart. I do this like day in, day out. The challenge what we see is the underlying technology.
You wake up, you take a shower, you think digital transformation.
Digital transformation, exactly, exactly. So, I mean, I get frustrated by many people. So digital can become an ivory tower thing as well, which is people are talking about those jazzy, especially consulting companies are, start talking about jazzy. We will define your experience. But for large enterprise, they can't make it real. So most of the journey mapping type of exercise or design thinking exercise which you do becomes a shelfware for the executives. So it means different to different people. So I crafted and, sort of, where did it start? So I have like a, as part of my notes taking, so in pre-digital world, we still were dealing with banks. We were dealing with payers, healthcare providers, and all these companies, right? I'm not sure if we were really happy, but we did not know any other way of doing things, right?
That was like not happy. It was the dark ages of
just exactly.
You're all analog.
We did not even know what a great thing looks like. Cut to comes the world of Google's and Amazon in last 2 decades, Uber and others. What they did was they fundamentally changed the way a company works with their constituents. So now my experience is my expectations are completely driven by what I do with Uber, what I do with Google, Amazon's, and all these Netflix and all these great companies of the world. So in response to that, I'm expecting the same from my bank. I'm expecting the same from my healthcare institutions. I'm expecting same from the government. Why can't it be that easy if these companies can do it? So now my experiences are driving it. So now these large organizations, mind it, they are configured, their processes, technology, people, culture were configured for the old days. Now they realize, are feeling the heat, that once you, my constituent doesn't want this, they want experience of Amazon. It's so hard for them to change all the different components of an organization, which is take your leadership, your culture, you take your technology landscape, you take your business models, right? So all this, changing all this together is truly digital transformation. I mean, it's a long talk, but that's the story I can articulate to myself and say, this is where it started. This is where we are right now. Phil, your turn.
What do you think, Phil?
All right, just tape that and let's go.
Yeah. Well, it's all recording. We can record 8 hours on YouTube. So, you know.
So I think that's, you know, just digging into those bits, right? Those, that is the part, I mean, that's going to be the core of this thing, right? You know, my questions were, I think, just in terms of having this conversation with somebody else, part of it would be, can you define it for the person who's not familiar? When I say digital transformation, what am I trying to get at? And I got the core of that, I think, out of what Shashi was saying. And I say this because I've been around a bunch of people talking about digital transformation, and it's like Bitcoin, man. Every time I walk away, I'm shaking my head thinking, what the hell are you trying to tell me with this blockchain thing, and why should I care? But as Shashi goes to that bit and says, you know what? The people have been changed by the experience of these technologies, and now they want that experience in other places. And I get it. And I'm saying, all right, okay, now where do we take that? And what is the opportunity inside of other organizations to deliver this way more seamless, way more self-serve experience that's available with other technologies? Does that... am I headed now in the right direction with this?
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
I think you're right. And, you know, Phil, to what you're saying, a definition, I've been looking for a definition of digital transformation and I didn't like them. So I did what I do best. I just make my own up.
Like Kobayashi Maru? Like you're
in true consultant fashion, I like to say.
So, I had a little inspiration from Chris, right? And so really when I looked at digital transformation, so what you're talking about, Shashi and Phil, what you're pointing at is, I just defined it as, and I call it the book of WB3, and WB3, my initials, if nobody knows.
wait, Phil, is it going to be divided up by book and chapter? So we'll say like the book of Bill, you know.
Absolutely.
Or section whatever.
It's going to be referenced just like you know, like a King James Bible and stuff like that.
Iambic pentameter, the whole thing.
Start with 2 Chronicles. Go ahead.
But like the definition is, here's how I define it. The implementation of human computer engineering to solve people problems. That's what digital transformation is.
Well, here's, I mean, just if I may gently call bullshit on that. yeah. No, but my bit is, so how does that different from what we've been doing all along? I get in the very beginning when we started with computers, we were just sort of amusing ourselves with them. And that's what we were doing in software development. Now, you know, we've been for a while trying to solve customer problems. So how can I, with digital transformation, how does my world look different? You know, if I'm transferring from black and white to color, who will notice that I've done this? How will they notice?
I accept the challenge.
All right.
but on that point, right? Because you know, depending on how Bill answer, well, depending on the lens Bill is using, right? It's going to change the answer. And I think, like, you know, if you're the customer, right? It's a different set of experiences and expectations. If you are, you know, a director, mid-level management in a large bank, right, somewhere in the Midwest, it's going to look completely different, right? It maybe takes on more like traditional project management, and I'm thinking about milestones and tasks. In other words, like, what lens are we looking through? Who, you know, and who is the audience? Who are we speaking to when we talk about it, right? So that's, yeah, sorry.
You know, you're spot on. Like, while I was, again, jotting down my stuff, so let's talk about the C-suite, right? What would digital transformation mean to a CEO? His company can go down if a new digital, native digital company comes up, you know, what Netflix did to Blockbuster. So he cares about digital business models. Can the business in which he is operating can be fundamentally be disrupted by a native digital company? That's what he cares about. Talk about chief marketing officer. What's their job? Their job is to generate the demand, right? To generate the demand. So what does that mean? So they care about constituent experience. So they care about digital experience, right? So the experience side of the digital transformation. So we covered digital business model, we covered digital experience. And then the third thing, which we talk about, is chief operating officer. They are always looking at trying to improve operations and stuff like that. There comes the digital technology piece, which talks about automation, robotic process automation. They talk about how do I leverage artificial intelligence, machine learning to provide, you know, world-class contact center experience, right? Chief financial officer, cut down my cost. How can I leverage digital technologies like automation specifically to cut down my cost? Now, automation is something which drives me crazy. Isn't what computers were supposed to do in the first place when we designed them? They were supposed to automate. But what we did is we automated very point problems, but now we are talking about automating at an enterprise level across the functions. So to piggyback on your idea, within an enterprise, which role are we talking about, who we are talking to, it means different to different people.
So Bill accepted the challenge. I interrupted, added another layer. Shashi piled on. All right, Bill, go answer the question.
The people problem. Business is always around solving people problems by delivering value. You know, that people problem. I hear there's a book with the people problem.
There's a book out there somewhere. I think if you you go to Amazon.com and you Google the people or search for the people problem, pretty sure there's at least one book on the subject.
Yeah, Chris, I think you can have another.
Chris's key to that and to the words the people problem, it shows up like number 10 on the list.
Yeah.
I give you a title for your next book. People are the problem.
I'm pretty sure he entertained that idea.
Yeah. Anyways.
Okay. So understanding that there's opportunities there, how does that change how I show up to work today? Right. As a consultant, right? How am I going to engage the client in a new way, or what sort of ideas am I going to infect them with, or are going to get into my work? Because I've realized there's potential for both an opportunity to improve what we're doing and an opportunity to stave off either present or future threats.
So what I feel is many times we try to, you know, help our clients. And everybody wants to do digital, and every executive wants to do it. If they are not doing it, they think they are missing the bus. Their profile is not rich enough. But what they don't understand it, what it takes to make this happen. They will engage consultants. Consultants will do some great stuff for them, but they are not ready to commit to the change which is required to make this happen. That happens all the time. $1 million spent on, you know, consulting companies, being the shelfware, they are not committed to it because they can't challenge the status quo. They don't want to fight that battle. Everything boils down to the leadership. And I'm not talking about like...
Let me just say I buy all of that. I buy what you're selling 100%. Okay, your job now is to get them to move. And you either got to set them on fire or show them a pot of gold. And I don't know what it's going to be, but how do you do that?
Hey, at the end... Yeah.
That's $1 million question right there. Well, actually, this is awkward. I have a FedEx package I have to sign for. I believe it's alcohol. So we'll discuss.
It's either alcohol or ammo. I don't know which is today. Yeah, hold on. We're going off to get it.
So the biggest, that's the challenge like we face all the time. And I agree with you. Part of it is our responsibility to make them realize how important that is. But most of the time, with this internal bureaucratic process, it takes forever for them. At the end of the day, we have to feed our family. We got to go to some other project where we are getting paid. So it has a definite start and an end date, and you can't be with them forever, unfortunately. Yeah,
so what question am I going to ask today? You know, let's imagine, like you said, you know, the world's a big place. My customers are big. It may take a long time for them to steer this ship in some other direction. But what question can I ask them today that'll get them thinking about this and feeling like this is a worthwhile endeavor? I don't think there is a perfect answer, but an answer, right? What is one of the tools I might use or one of the questions I might use to get this ball rolling?
Yeah. So there's a couple, I think there's two things there, you know, in terms of like, what action would I take tomorrow to help my client understand the value and what they can get out of it and that sort of thing. I think on the one side, there's some things that we can say, demonstrate, use evidence from other companies in their industry, other industries, et cetera, to show how a successful transformation went elsewhere. And generally, you know, if you're at a large company and you're using the mom and pop shop down the street as your example, that's not good, right? They want to see a peer. So what did my peer do that enabled them to make an extra dollar or have a higher score on the customer service report for the year or whatever? How did they get there? How did they make that happen? And so we can show, well, they did these things. So there's some telling that goes on. I think there's also some, it's not like brute force, but there's a degree of like, you're doing something wrong here. And the way that we know that is some glaring things that pop up that say, this is not really a digital transformation that's going to succeed. For example, if it's a 5-year plan, right? Right. If it is, hey, we're doing a digital transformation by buying this product over here and installing it, right? Hey, we're doing a digital transformation because we hired a bunch of consultants and we have a strategy to upgrade from AIX version 5.1 to AIX version 5.8. And you can see some alarm bells that go off and you can demonstrate that. So that actually takes some analytical skill to go out and say, look, you know, I'm observing what I see. Here are the warning signs. These are the things that will not get you where you need to go. Not that they're not worth doing, but they're not a digital transformation.
I think that's a completely valid technique for having those sets of questions. I mean, to me, that's kind of the set of questions and that I might ask once someone's decided I'm interested in moving forward with this in some way. I'm willing to investigate it, right? You know, a question I would have to you, you know, particularly you guys who are working into, you know, larger clients, is there, you know, if you think about that curve of, you know, am I aware of it? Am I interested in it? Am I willing to do something about it? Where are they in that thermometer gauge, right? Where are they in that space?
I think in the current state where we are, the question that any client is not asking why I need to do digital transformation. Convincing the client to take that first step is we are gone that past phase. Now we are at a time
maybe,
where we
maybe need they to should ask. Maybe they should be asking why, but yeah, okay, I agree.
I mean, all of them are convinced, and the reasons could be different because everybody else is doing it, right? B, they are smart enough to actually understand that how their industry is being disrupted or can be disrupted. They need to do something about it. But I think largely we are gone past that stage. We are at a stage where they have question about how do I do this? How do I make it real? How do I make digital real? What it means to me and what can you do for me? So those are the questions they're looking for answers rather than why I should be doing digital. Nobody's asking that question.
Maybe I'm just repeating what you guys are saying and really just to get a grasp of it. I mean, Chris is laughing, so he's like, yeah.
No, I think that's funny, right? It's like, you know, I haven't talked in a while, so I'm going to say something, and maybe I'm just repeating what you all just said already.
I need to get my minute in here.
Let me recapture that in a slightly clearer version.
But it was really going back to, from what I'm saying, now I just lost my point.
I'm sorry.
I started it by making the snide comment.
Bill, just start the sentence with, what I think I'm hearing you say is.
I love the online mentoring. This is awesome. So.
He charges for that, by the way, Bill.
I'm growing in front of the world.
Exactly.
I like it.
But it's
way too fast.
They grow so fast. Anyways, it gets back to you were talking about the business model. It's using the computer. It's using, I'll go back to human-computer interaction, but it's using computers to redefine your business model. It's using digitization to redefine your business model or finding new opportunities there. Okay, I'm off this point. Let's go to the next one. I had something in my head.
You know, I keep coming back, you know, and I think, Phil, you asked the question. I think it's completely legitimate, right, and important. Because if you go with the idea that digital transformation can mean different things to different constituents, depending on how you're looking at it, has different modes of operating and achieving a transformation, right? All of that kind of stuff. I keep coming back to, okay, great. If I'm sitting here and I'm watching this on my lunch break on my phone, or I'm sitting in the John or whatever at my, you know, big company in New York, and I'm watching this, which that's a whole nother problem. But anyway, What do I walk out of here and do differently? I don't know, back to the point, I don't know that there's an answer to that other than, you know, kind of what Shashi said, or, you know, what you alluded to is, you know, how do, you know, maybe it's the Apple logo, the Apple spoken, right? You got to think differently somehow. And that's easy and glib to say, right? But I mean, at the core of it, isn't that what we're saying?
But, yes.
That's what I'm saying.
Maybe. Go ahead, Phil. Sorry.
No. I mean, I think that is it. And what I was trying to do in my way of questioning was to say, what does that specifically mean, right? So as a consultant, I think that is, if I'm in a company that seems to be open to this idea, then I want to pull on the threads that they present. For the company that's not there at that level already, or maybe I see a process and I think there's really some opportunity for some disruption there, I think I want to ask the questions, you know, are there ways that we could bring systems into play that either deliver more transparency, that deliver more engagement with the client, or, you know, cut costs if that's the way it is. But I mean, right now, a lot of what we're doing, I mean, a good sophisticated company, they're operationally excellent, right? That's not the problem. They're good at what they do, but some cat is going to come in and do it different. And when that one comes in, that's where they get into trouble.
Exactly. Because when mind it, all these processes, technologies, and everything has a shelf life. Even culture has a shelf life. All these things were defined to stand up an organization to serve a purpose at point in time, which lived for, let's say, 5 years or 10 years ago. Then the generation changed. Demographics changes. There are other entrants, other experiences, which we keep on getting. It's time for company to go back. And then need to reconfigure and relook at all these four things again. Companies don't do it. It's like usual house cleaning, right? You just got to do those stuff anyways. Whether it's digital today, 10 years from now, we'll come up with some other buzzword. Transformation has to happen. Whether it's digital, whether it's we may go back to analog or whatever it is, like Amazon going back buying brick and mortar stores, insurance companies going and opening retail stores or brick and mortar stores to interact with their consumers. So they are taking a step back. I don't know if it's a step back, but the point is they are trying to find right balance between 100% digital versus 100% physical. So it means, and second question is company or the leadership of the company trying to truly look at disruption in a digital means, or they are looking at improving or incrementally improving their experiences through digital channels and other stuff? So these are some of the questions they need to answer.
Have we changed the way we look at business? So traditionally, think pre-80s, pre-90s, pre-90s type deal. Our business models, I mean, like, was it the average S&P person was on there for something like 61 years? Now they're on there for something like 18 years and the S&P 500 of companies in there. Mm-hmm. Have we, through digitization, through digitalization and taking in this computer as our third arm, have we changed the way we look at business by introducing new business models in a really quick, rapid succession? And because now we can access all 6-7 billion people on this earth, we're now fundamentally changing the way we interact as human beings. And it's not a digital transformation. Maybe it's more of a societal and worldwide transformation, but we see the symptom as increasing digitalization.
I think what I'm hearing you say is, right, that the transformation that we're talking about, when we talk about a digital transformation, yes, there's technology. Yes, there's methodology. There's process. But at the core of it, we're talking about transforming how people interact with each other through various channels, right? And, I will confess, like when I was first thinking about, digital transformation, my head's in, you know, the weeds right now at a particular client. And, you know, I'm thinking of, you know, the process of transformation being focused almost exclusively on technology where I'm at right now. And so my aha moment was like, aha, transformation for them. It's really, yeah, you're upgrading the stuff. That's great. Wonderful. Put 100 engineers on that. Go upgrade, put everything in the cloud, Bitcoin, blockchain, whatever you're doing. But fundamentally, you have to alter how you deliver these things. In other words, the transformation for me, you know, was an internal set of way of working that is almost entirely people-based. And again, I hate to keep going back to the people problem, but right, it's it seems so obvious. It's not working because Bill doesn't talk to Bob, and Bob doesn't know anything about what, you know, Suanne is, I don't think Suanne's name, but whatever, you know, whatever her name is over there, nobody knows what she's doing. You know, they're not talking to each other, and it's like, oh, we're going to digitally transform by, you know, putting it in the cloud, putting our app in the cloud, or putting our product in the cloud. And I'm just thinking, like, put the product in the cloud, right? Great. You will fail faster, right? The process will break faster now, right? Because you have this complete dysfunction on at a people level. And so maybe, Bill, maybe there's something to what you're saying, right? Is that, you know, was it Thomas Kuhn who said in his book something about, you know, the I should have had the book, you know, should have had it come to mind before I like mentioned it. Fuck, I just like completely blanked on. Anyway, the point is, right, that, you know, we've fundamentally altered how we deliver things, how we interact, and our business models are. I don't know if it's cause or effect, but they fundamentally altered as well.
Yep. So, and maybe going off on that, so thinking about the person in their New York office right now and Phil tying back to an answer, maybe the digital transformation, stop looking at it as a noun and thinking it more of as a verb. And I'm going to have to admit, I've taken sort of this perspective from somebody I was speaking with a couple weeks ago when we were talking about enterprise architecture. It was a great interview, and they're like, I don't look at enterprise architecture as a noun, it's a verb. He's like, if I'm doing it well, nobody knows I'm doing it. And I'm like, oh, I love that perspective. Maybe that's what digital transformation is. And so as the person watching this is getting off their lunch break or walking out of God knows wherever they're watching this, they're thinking, I'm not going to walk into my C-suite, my executive director, and say, I'm going to do digital transformation. What they're going to walk in, they're going to say, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start incrementally altering the way we deliver business value, increase our bottom line, and, you know, I'll be back to you in 2 months with my financial results. And then under the hood, what they're going to do is now they're going to go into do quote unquote digital transformation. I'm going to grab my tech guys. I'm going to grab the 10% of the people out here who want to push things on the edge. I'm going to listen to them, how they implement technology, how they make their lives easier. And then in 2 months, I'm going to be able to deliver a business value back to my executive, my C-suite, or prove that out. But in the communication, digital transformation was actually never used as a noun. It was a verb. It was a means to an end.
This is a grand idea. It's a good one, right? And it's something that you can figure out, because I think all kinds of businesses are susceptible to both benefits and disruptions from this. You know, benefits if they're able to do it, some disruption if someone else gets to some bit of this first and you end up reacting to it. But I like the idea of saying, what, you know, let's assume, again, an operationally excellent company has already figured out what their key performance indicators are. And I don't mean that from a jargon standpoint, but I don't think it's just revenue, right? It could be engagement, it could be minutes on site. There's all kinds of things, but whatever that thing is that they feel like their key performance indicator is, you know, what are my opportunities for digital transformation? What are my opportunities to say, yeah, I know I'm probably delivering a physical good from A to B or to you at a particular time and place, but how can I go back and make sure that I'm delivering that either with better information, better transparency? You know, I was just in a meeting this past week and I watched a bunch of high-powered guys whose primary job was logistics, and I had no appreciation for just how hard it was for them to know where their stuff was when it involved coming over the ocean, right? I mean, they don't know. You know, they are the number one shippers in the state, the number two shipper in the state, and they don't know where their stuff is. They said, man, if you could figure out the problem, help us figure out how to get visibility into that, you'd be way ahead.
By the way, before anyone answers, where is it? Here it is. It's Thomas Kuhn. The structure of the scientific revolution. He actually coined the phrase paradigm shift. So he did disruption before disruption was cool.
That's great. Did you just print that book?
I did. I actually have a print on demand service in my my office here.
It was in that case of beer.
It was in my humidor over here.
I see that.
Yeah. Right. Any parting thoughts on digital transformation, what it means, how to actually as a practitioner, you know, execute against it, those kinds of things.
I think this is a good framework. It's a strong idea. And if I were out there, again, I'd pull on the threads that are already extant in my company, right? Someone's thinking about it. Let's go figure out what the opportunities were there. If I think that for some reason we've been blind to it for one reason or another, I think I would be asking myself, what is the stuff I'm absolutely certain that we are awesome at? And then what if I'm wrong?
I'm writing that down. That's really good stuff.
Every company should be transforming every 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. So there is a wave of transformation. And this wave of transformation is fueled or enabled by digital mindset, digital business model, digital technologies, right? So that's for me is the key. In order for us to make this successful, I think consulting companies need to partner with their client and co-invest in some of those capabilities and change their behavior. If we don't change the behavior, this is like one of those transformation. By the time companies realize their transformation, the phase or the life shelf life of that is over, and you are looking at something new before you have realized this one. So that's my worry, but something which we got to look for. It's nothing new for me.
Old hat for Shashi. Got it.
I think as you look at digital transformation, this is me coming from some recent couple years of experience trying to drive digital transformation. What I deem as digital transformation. So what I've learned is if you're going to take on digital transformation, I go back to the verb versus the noun. You're not doing a thing. You're acting with some practices and methodologies to achieve an outcome. But you have to realize you are becoming the change agent. And I think this may be where it fails. And I look at back on my historical failures or things that I've crossed, is I didn't want to be a change agent in certain areas. And that's why it may have not as gone as far as it could. It may not have been as efficient. Areas it was effective, less effective. So you had to take that on and become the change agent. And I think that's why you see when we take the supply chain example, you have to fight for those resources. What are the resources? Is you have to look at it from a different lens and different perspective to facilitating that means to an end. But then I get back to a book. So we're talking about books is Orbiting the Giant Hairball. So think about change agent, but there's this one called Orbiting the Giant Hairball. It was passed to me when I was at Boeing. And it's really about how, and it goes back to Paul, what you're talking about is in an organization where it does a lot, you can be extremely organizationally effective on one thing, you really deliver really well, and you're thinking about transformation in other areas. But how do you orbit this hairball of processes, policies, this existing organization, but then still be able to drive change? And so hopefully that some coherent thoughts tied together, there's probably a bunch of illicit assumptions in there that people are like, what are you talking about? But I'm thinking and thinking out loud is be a change agent and understanding you're orbiting a giant hairball and what that means, because if you're going to pursue digital transformation, you've now taken on the responsibility from, you know, head to toe to see this through. And if you're a technical expert, understand that you now have to become a people person. If you're a people person, understand you're going to have to take on a level of technical expertise so you can start communicating with people who are technical experts. And I think that's the reality.
Love it. Awesome. Okay. Good. Guys, this was great. I now know everything I need to know about digital transformation. I'm going to go out and do it right now. And hopefully everyone watching this can take something away after all of this that they can actually use to great effect. So thank you, Phil, Bill, Shashi. I'm Chris. We'll see you next time. Thanks, guys.